So this is Ryan from Hip Hop Kings speaking with Ruste Juxx. How you doing, man?
Salute, man. I'm doing good. Doing great, man.
Good. Thank you for inviting me through to the the crib and chilling. I appreciate it, man. So what I wanted to ask first is you've recently announced an upcoming album called International Juxx.
Yeah.
Which is obviously a collaboration between you and artists and fans from all over the world.
Right.
What was the idea to create that album? Where did that come from?
I don't know. I just came up with it, man. I was like, I thought that would be a great idea, man. I never heard any other artists doing that. So, I appreciate all my fans, you know what I'm saying? So I thought this would be a great opportunity for them because I do a lot of features with people from all over, so I'm used to doing that and getting on songs with them, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, you know, I should do an album featuring my fans, even the producers, you know, not just the rappers, you know, every beat that's produced on the album is, you know, from my Juxaholics, you know what I mean? That's what I call them. So, and it worked out great, man. And my man Archetype, who produced my VIC album, you know what I mean, he mixed and mastered it. And so we got that, you know, in the chamber ready to blast off right after, you know, I'm done with Media Right. You know.
So which artists from what countries across the world feature on this album?
I don't remember everybody's name, but nobody's really known, but it's a bunch of dope artists, man. Word.
And that's from the likes of Africa and Europe and places like that.
One song I got like two African rappers, one from Senegal, one from Senegal and what else? I forget the other place, man. But then I got artists from Denmark, Australia, from Poland, Russia, Mexico. You know what I'm saying? I'm mixing it all up. You know what I mean? Even the producers from a bunch of places, man. And it came out great. For Nigeria, that's where it's one from Senegal, one from Nigeria. Word. And they, you know, they all rapping in their language. And everybody got busy, man. You know, some people, you know, at first I didn't like it at first. And, you know, I just told them to send me another one. I got artists from the UK as well. A female rapper from Lebanon. Like, it's just all mixed up, man. Everybody, you know what I mean? Everybody did their thing. Everybody don't have their name, their credits, you know what I'm saying? And where they came from. And I even had one of my fans, Billy Bonks, he did the album cover. And he did it so perfect, you know what I'm saying? I'm just like sitting at the table with like the world leaders, you know, from all different countries and the flags is in the back. And you know what I mean? I'm just blessed, man. And I wanted to show love back to the fans by doing this, you know? And you know, after I put the album out, maybe I'm gonna shoot the video, and you know, have them shoot their part, and you know, then have it put together, so everybody will really get their shine. You know what I'm saying? It'll be even better.
So creatively, I mean, it's obviously very different than collaborating with a bunch of people in the same country.
Yeah.
Did you have any challenges about creating the album that were not expected, or did it all kind of come together pretty well after you started the ball rolling?
It came together pretty well, man, because I didn't have to, you know, in some certain album, you're working on an album and you're looking for, you know, you doing collabs with other rappers and you're waiting, they might take long, or, you know, the process might, you know, be slow, but everybody was on it, you know what I mean? They was like, all right, yeah, they was ready to do it, so they sent it quick, and it was just, the problem was it was so many artists that I was dealing with, you know what I'm saying? I just got to keep track of everybody because the label's not doing it, it's just me. And I got to keep track of everybody, where they from, and you know, who's who and everything. And but I'm going to do volume 1 and volume 2 because I got so many joints, you know? Okay. So, you know, it's just great, man.
And that leads on to me asking, actually, what is the situation with putting out the record? Is it going to be an independent?
Yeah, definitely. I'm going to do it through either Shinigami or Duck Down, or I might just put it out myself through TuneCore. You know what I mean? If you know if those two don't work out, I'm going to just put it out myself. So either way, it's dropping, you know? It's already done.
So you're obviously keeping busy because Meteorite wasn't out so long ago. And obviously you're already planning the release of International Juxx.
Right.
Like you mentioned before, you're very popular with featuring on other artists' material as well.
Yeah.
Are there any other projects that you've got planned or confirmed for this year?
Hell yeah, I got like 5-6 albums done, you know. Also, I got another album, well, EP out, another album with called Death by Stereo, produced by the Beat Bruisers, and it's featuring Pause One, Mando the DJ, and that dropped a little before Meteorite, so I'm still promoting that too at the same time, and that album came out crazy. And they were from Cali, you know what I'm saying? So I went out there, I did radio, videos, interviews and everything, and did good promotion with that, and I came back. And you know, I got to work on this. And then next, I got after International Juxx, I got another album with Kayo Itachi. It's called Killer Cartels, featuring me and Miles Grimes. Just me and him rhyming back to back. And you know, Kayo on the beats. And that album is crazy, we been did that. And so I got another album with a Canadian producer called The Last Composer. And we didn't title that album yet, but you know, that's done. Another album with a producer from Bill Blake. He's from Minneapolis, and that album is crazy. Like, I just got a few joints, man, and you know, just ready to go back to back. I mean, it's gonna seem like I'm doing it right there, but some of them already had it done. You know what I mean? It's just strategically how I'm gonna put them out. You know?
I get that. So then following these releases, or certainly International Juxx,
yeah.
Are there any plans to tour perhaps through the UK and Europe and wider?
Yeah, definitely, man. I'm going on tour right now with King Magnetic. We doing like a West Coast run. We hitting a lot of spots like Vegas, Cali, Arizona. And then after that, I dropped an EP with producer/rapper Omen 44. He's from Japan. Before the Death by Stereo. And I'm getting ready to go on tour with him in Japan for like 7 shows after this King Magnetic tour, the Magmar tour. So after that, then by the summertime, I'm gonna be ready to go to Europe, you know? So me and Kyle could do the run for Meteorite, and you know, International Juxx should be out at around that same time. So I'm gonna definitely try to do that. And then, you know, whenever I'm in whatever state, with some of the artists that's on the album, you know, they're gonna have them come out to the shows and do their part, you know? So it all come together great, man.
Good. And before we finish, I know you're rocking the hat, but I just wanted to take this opportunity to say, obviously, shout out to
the video, man.
Yeah, man. Sean Price, gone way too early, obviously.
Word.
I mean, other than him being a mentor, really, how instrumental has he been in your career, and how much of a legacy do you think he's gonna leave in hip hop?
Man, I think he wanted his name to be, you know, recognized, and I think it is. Like all the fans, I've seen so many murals all over the world, like so many people getting attached, and his music is timeless, you know. And I'm glad to be a part of his history. And he definitely, he set me up right. Like, I toured with him so many places all over the world, and that made me a better performer, made me a better artist. I seen how he dealt with promoters, how he dealt with the fans, and all the features that I was on with him, the classics. And he helped me with my career so much by just doing that, you know? And putting me on all his albums and just everything, you know what I mean? He was a real big brother to me, man. Like, I have a big brother, and he looked out for me all the time, real life and, you know, and music too. Well, he's my son, my second son's godfather, so, you know, he's close.
And lastly, is there any final shout outs or thanks you want to give to anybody who might be watching?
Yeah, man, I just want to thank everybody, man, that's been riding with me from the beginning of my career to now, or even just, you know, newcomers, everybody that's listening to Ruste Juxx music, man, and I appreciate everything. And you can go get that Death by Stereo that's on iTunes, or get Meteorite that's on iTunes as well. And you know, look out for my new videos, my new projects, and I'm gonna keep it rolling, man.